And hello to you, gang. It's Thursday, the 23rd of March, 2017. Well, a warm welcome along to today's United Kingdom talk. A little bit late this evening, or this afternoon, rather. And the reason is I've just been trying to think all day, really, what to say about the attacks in London, of course, yesterday afternoon. And it's all over the news. It's all over the newspaper. And apart from saying, you know, what a terrible thing it is to happen, and it's just unbelievable. It just shows you how easy it is, doesn't it, really, when you think about it, you know? All you've got to do is have a car. You haven't got to have bombs or guns or anything like that. You just need a car. How many of us have got cars? It's just so easy. And I think we'll leave it to the news channels and the newspapers about that, really, don't you? And we're just doing a normal show. I tell you what our surprise, the woman jumping in the River Thames, did you see that? You know, to avoid the terrorists, not necessarily a good idea. I mean, there's some really strong currents in that water, you know. People have been trying, been swimming there before. Very strong undercurrents, which drag you under. So not always necessarily a good idea to jump in the river, although obviously the lady felt safer doing that, didn't she? And as always, you know, disgusted by people taking selfies. It beggars belief, doesn't it? How people can take selfies while standing with something terrible going behind them. I've seen it at crashes. You know, when you've been driving along on a motorway and you see people taking selfies of crashes. What the hell's all that about? Yeah, it says in the Daily Mail today, a passerby who appeared to take photos with a selfie stick. With a selfie stick. In front of victims of the Westminster terror attack has sparked fury. At least five people have died when a terrorist brought carnage to central London. That's in the Daily Mail today. And there's this one taking selfies. I mean, it's just, it beggars belief, doesn't it? It really beggars belief. Let's say hello to some of the early people who are with us on the show. Oh, we've just got Rod Brown there today. There we go. Stephen's there. Hello, Stephen. All right, Stephen. Oh, I've got three cameras in here now, incidentally. I've got to get used to how it all works. So we've got three cameras in here now. There's one over there. One over there with the date. The usual one right in front of me there. And I've got one over the side there as now for when I look over there. It's getting better and better, isn't it, eh? Oh, we do try. We do try. There's a phone line open, by the way, boys and girls. If you want to call in at some point, it's 020-8144-3477. Local London number, OK? Hello to Rod as well. Hello, Rod. 020-8144-3477. We're also on Periscope as well now, boys and girls. We're going to go back on Periscope for a while. But generally, you want to be watching the show on Facebook. That's where you get the different cameras and words come up and little captions and things like that. That all only happens on Facebook, whether it's a recording or the live show, OK? So 020-8144-3477 is my phone number. Or you can Skype in as well on the Skype in United Kingdom Talks. Nice to see Stephen. You're down in Australia, aren't you, I think? Hello to Ronan today. Hello, Ronan. Have you got your new job on the planes? Aren't you on something else other than British Airways now? I think you are. Something other than British Airways. We'll take more care of you. Fly the flag. Fly the flag. I know you want to be on back on British Airways. How could you leave them, dear? I mean, if I was going in economy, you'd get at least a fun-sized Mars bar for your lunch and a tiny little sandwich. Is that right, lovey? It's all gone wrong on British Airways. Hello to Jim Fannon. Hello, Jim. He's with us as well. And Daniel, of course. Daniel down there in Camberley. Nice to see you all. And welcome along to our little show. It'll be a little bit less long. Shorter than it is normally today, OK? Ronan's off on Monday. Oh, well, good luck to you, Ronan. My mate's just come back from New York. He was there for, I think, a week. He got delayed because of the snowstorm out there, but he went Virgin Atlantic the top. Is that upper class? I think he went upper class and had a really nice time on the plane. He had his little pyjamas. Apparently, he put his little pyjamas on. He was supposed to come around this afternoon, but I've been let down. Let down. There I was, sitting all alone in my living room, scanning the TV channels, watching more terrible things happening in the world, and no friend to talk to. But never mind. Don't worry about little old me sitting here all on my own. Yes. Can I just do some of the messages from yesterday's show? We were talking about job searching. Now, this is something I haven't done for years. I mean, I have in a way, but not like, how can you put it, someone with a normal job would do job searching. You know, I do job searching by going on Facebook and saying, hello, I've got a Saturday night free. Is there any quiz night jobs or karaoke nights going anywhere? That's how I would normally do it. Or pick up the phone. Oh, hello. Is that the nightclub? Yes, I've got a night free. Have you got any jobs? That's how I do it. I don't really understand now how to get a proper job. When I was a child, okay, not a child, but when I was younger, the way you got a job was to walk in, ring up, apply to a firm. They would send you a application form, there were no CVs. That old CV, that's a load of old rubbish, that is, CVs. If you're good at writing a CV, you can get a job. You're not necessarily the right person for the job. And I just don't go along with CVs. You need to meet the person, I think. We never had CVs. We just got an application form, you filled it in, and generally you got an interview. Much more difficult now, I think, to get a job. Those of you that haven't got jobs, Simon, we were talking about that the other day. Simon wrote in, basically, people have to do 35 hours a week job searching. Well, I mean, it's just the same as having a job, isn't it? How can you search for 35 hours a week to find a job? Does that mean you're just sitting there on a computer and all that? Cool, dear. It's on a government site called Universal Job Match. If they don't, they get sanctioned, which means if you get £500 a month, which includes everything, you will only get the housing benefit of it for 3 months. So in other words, they will get 200 quid to pay rent and everything else to live on, which is impossible. So that is what it means. But it's complicated. Universal Job Match has its own job vacancy site. Oh, I might have a look at that. Just to see how all that works, Simon. That's interesting, that. Joanna said on yesterday's show, you are so terrible, Chris, talking about bananas hard and soft. Yeah, funnily enough, I mentioned bananas yesterday. I was doing the quiz last night. Nice quiz last night. It's not over busy at the quiz at the moment. So if you want to come down next Wednesday, it probably won't be busy now until Easter. What we have in the period coming up to Easter, it goes quiet. Generally, everywhere, although I have to say Central Station hasn't gone quiet at all after saying that. But generally, for some unbeknown reason to me, as you come up towards the Easter Sunday, most things go a bit quiet. Then Easter comes and it gets busy and it's okay and it goes back to normal after that. I've never really understood that because the same thing doesn't happen at Christmas. You know, it doesn't kind of get quiet going up to Christmas. So why is it that it goes quiet going up to Easter? And once Easter's come and gone, then that's the end of it. There, everything's normal again. So if you want a chance, an even better, let me tell you, you've got so much more chance of winning my quiz than the National Lottery. Okay, so we might not be giving away £12 million, but then again, we might. Who knows? I could walk into the quiz next Wednesday and my lovely manager, Ashley, oh, she's lovely, she is, will please people stop to asking Ashley to stand up. She is. She is a munchkin, the same as myself. We are small people. We are small people. Will people stop asking us to stand up? We are already. Thank you very much. But if you come along to the quiz next Wednesday, you've got an even better chance of winning possibly £1 million or possibly a £30 bar tab, depending on what's given to me at the time. Eh? You could even win a Justin Bieber album. Yes, but are you clever enough? That's the questions, lovey. So do join us next week if you want a better chance of winning at the King's Head Theatre Bar Quiz, Upper Street in Islington, Wednesday nights from 8:30, all right? So a nice little journey to the quiz. I did the quiz. We had a nice night. It wasn't too many of us. I think we had 5 teams altogether instead of 10. But it was lovely. And afterwards, I was saying to people, you know, I must stop going down to Five Guys. Now, Five Guys is like a posh burger place. It's expensive. Because I'm not having bread for Lent, I've now managed to cut down to a small portion of chips. What are they called? Spicy chips. Oh, I'm just eating a bit of my finger, sorry. do you do that? Look at the side of my finger, look at it. Bits of skin coming off there that I like to eat. Do you do that? I think it's better than eating your nails, because nails are filthy, disgusting things. You could kill an entire village with the stuff underneath your nails, with a bacteria that is emanating from there. Yeah, watch out for that, my loves. I can't remember now. No, I can't remember for some reason. No, I've lost the plot now, haven't I? I lost the plot. Anyway, so I was, what was I talking about? My nails or something. Five Guys, that's it. I'm back on track. We're back in the room. Hello, you're back in the room. Yeah, Five Guys. So I also go to Five Guys. Cajun, thank you. Cajun chips. And a nice vanilla shake. But that's like £10.50. It's a bit dear, isn't it? I don't mind going into a restaurant and spending 15, 20 quid. But a burger shop, at the end of the day, it's a burger shop. Now, the thing is, if you do get chips in Five Guys, what they tend to do is you've got your small, medium and large, which I think is regular, small, regular and large. I can't remember the exact sizes. You only want a small. And I tell you why. You've got the small cup. They fill up the cup. What they do, they're very generous with the portions in there. I'll give them that. They absolutely are generous with the portions. The staff tend to be very helpful and very happy. That it's okay in there. It's not like going in some of these places. Oh, you know, you wonder why these people are working in there. So miserable. Especially the Starbucks. Starbucks, a lot of those are as miserable as sin, aren't they? God, blimey. Why do you want to be sitting there on a front desk serving customers when you want to look like that, dear? Anyway, so they fill up the cup. Then they put it in a plastic, in a paper bag, and then they shove another load of chips in there. So you only ever need to buy this, unless you're a great big fat bastard and you're greedy. You might want a large one then. But I find the small one is enough. They put the cup of chips in there, and then they sling a load more chips in on top. All right. So that's all you need there. And I've got something in my mouth. What is it? Oh, it's that bit of skin I haven't swallowed yet. And I have a vanilla shake. But that's like £10.50. And I find that a bit expensive. So I was saying that to one of the staff. And he said, what else do you like? I said, well, I quite like spaghetti. She said, oh, you want to try the place down just a few doors down. She said, you get a great big box of pasta and whatever you want on top, £5. So I said, I like my favourite is spaghetti arrabbiata. Arrabbiata, you know, the spicy one. I can never say it. That's the spaghetti I like. So I finished work and I walked down the road and I found this little place. And I walked in. I said, do you do arrabbiata? And she said, yes, sir, we do, sir. I said, can I have one of those, please? She said, OK. I said, what time do you close? She said, 11 o'clock. She said, you're still all right for 25 minutes or so. All right then. So and it's like a restaurant. So it's the back of the restaurant. OK. So I was standing there and I said, can I use your toilet? She said, just down there. And there's a door and it says poo room. Oh, no. I mean, it put me off the restaurant, to be honest. I know that's what it's for. But to have a sign saying poo room. No. Not in a restaurant, for God's sake, man. So I went and used that. And I come back out again. I said, do you mind if I sit down? Have I still got time to sit down and eat that? She said, yeah, of course you can. She said, it will be a little bit more extra. I said, that's fine, my darling. So I sat down there and about 10 minutes later, I suppose it was, because it's all cooked fresh. Out came pasta and that arrabbiata sauce, or whatever it's called. Arrabbiata, you know what? You know the one I mean. Arrabbiata sauce. I thought I should have said spaghetti, but it came as pasta. So that doesn't matter. It's exactly the same. It's not long and thin, is it? You know, little round things. And I said, I've never been here before. And she laughed. I think she was Italian. Lovely lady. And she said, well, I hope you like it. Anyway, I started eating it. Oh, my God, it was lovely. Oh, it blew my head off. There must have been a lot of chilli in that one. Oh, it was lovely. I do like chilli. Oh, I love it. And I sat there, a little bit of Parmesan cheese on top. And I can't. I'll find out the name of the restaurant for you next week. I'll probably pop in there again next week as well. Because generally on a Wednesday night, I've had lunch, but then I've gone to sleep. I've got up again and gone straight to work. I don't have anything to eat generally before. I'll tell you why. Shall I? Yeah. All right. I'll tell you why. You know why? I've told you so many times. I generally don't have anything to eat before I leave the house because I've got a bit of irritable bowel syndrome. OK, and I've worked out when I have something to eat, generally within an hour, I need to go. So you don't want to be tempting fate. You really don't. So now I don't have anything before I go to work. And I generally have something at work or afterwards on a Wednesday afterwards. And I've been going in Five Guys and that or wait until I get home. So I generally have something to eat afterwards. So I'll pop in there again next week, perhaps. Maybe I can get a couple of photographs while I'm in there. But highly recommended. Lovely little place, quiet. It's like long and narrow. They've got all pictures on the wall of like films and things like that. And it's I'll tell you where it is if you're in Islington. If you're in Islington, OK, the place where I do on a Wednesday night is the King's Head Theatre Bar. That's where I do the quiz. So if you were going away from Islington... and away from London, it's the King's Head Theatre Bar's on the left, and it's about 3 minutes walk down from there, and it's a purple, the front of it's purple. Okay, so the front of it's purple, and it's really nice. So well worth a visit there, okay, Spaghetti Arabettia. Then I came out there, and on the way home, I've now found a nice little chicken, fried chicken shop and burgers and things like that on the roundabout, on the Chiswick, I think it's the Kew roundabout or the Chiswick roundabout. It's on the Chiswick side. And there's a big Esso garage. But if you were about to go from Chiswick over Kew Bridge, before you get to Kew Bridge, it's just there on the left, some chicken shop. And they do, I found it completely by accident the other night, they do milkshakes. £2.39. Well, that's a lot better than the fiver I was paying at Five Guys. And don't get me wrong, the milkshakes are lovely at Five Guys, but they're just as lovely at the little chicken shop run by a couple of Asian lads in there. And they're really nice. They're ever so nice to talk to. And they recognise me now. As soon as they see me, they put the milkshake on before I've even got to the counter. And usually you get a couple of cabbies in there, you know, so while you're standing there having a waiting for it to happen, you have a bit of a chat with them. Because I chat to anyone while I'm out, believe it or not. I don't chat to people as much as I talk to you, I don't think. You know, you win the award for listening to the most crap from me coming out of my mouth. It's true. So I had that. Very nice. What I do is I take that in the home and I have a little sip it sort of on the way home. Got back in the car on the motorway on the way home. And came back, and I think I went straight to bed last night, actually. Sure, I went straight to bed, got up this morning, had my breakfast, went over to the swimming pool, went up to pick up a second camera, because I bought... The reason I've got three cameras in it, I've now bought a second wide-angle camera, which is the one over there with the date on it. I've got to set up another thing so that the date's not on there, but that's how I'll open in future, with that one over there and then to the one in front of me. So that's a wide angle one there. The one that was over there before, I've now put over this side. So that's the little one over there, which kind of does it like that. And I just and of course we got the main one directly in front of us there. And I just think it makes it a little bit more interesting, do you? The fact that you can, you know, go to different places with the picture now and again. Or maybe you don't think it makes any difference at all. It might be a whole waste of time. Anyway, so I went swimming, came back here, had a bit of lunch. I had a letter to post, so I went out and posted a letter. I'm getting so much crap through the letterbox. I mean, look at it all. Look at all this blooming stuff. People trying to sell me blinds, cruises. I'd like to go on a cruise again, I think. What I like about cruises is that you don't actually have to go to an airport, do you? You can just drive to Southampton. Well, I mean, if you get the one that goes from Southampton. Oh, here's one here, look. Right, so this one. Hang on a minute. This is in a day. Oh, that's lovely. Look at that. Oh, look at that little house there. Isn't that lovely? Look at that. Oh, I don't think that's the place you go to, though, is it? It says a Canary Islands and Madeira cruise. Departs March the 16th. That's next year. How much is that then? 16 days for £2,000. Now, that's not... Oh, that's for two people, that is. That's for two people. See, so if I went on my own, that would still be £2,000. This is a problem with going on holiday on your own. But I've honestly, I've tried to go on holiday with a few different people. Now, other than family... If I go with family, it works. If I go with anyone else other than family, it doesn't work. Honestly, it doesn't. You just end up having rows. It's terrible. So I won't go on holiday with anyone else anymore other than my family. But this is, look, so the itinerary, Tilbury. So you go from Tilbury, okay? I don't know. Can you park there? I don't know. I'd have to look into that. Amsterdam, I've never been there. Gibraltar, not been there. Lanzarote, not been there. Las Palmas, Gran Canaria, I've been there. Santa Cruz de Tenerife, Madeira, Lisbon, and back to Tilbury. That's not bad, is it? And that would include all your food and everything, you know. I don't know about drinks, but I think something's been done to that photo, don't you? I mean, it don't really look that colour, does it? Or you can go. Here's one. Christmas and New Year's cruise. Now, I'd quite like to go away one Christmas, I think. I think that would be quite nice. Christmas has never really been the same since my parents passed away. 2000 was my mum and 1996 was my dad. I go out with my sisters usually, which is lovely, but not the same. Do you know what I mean? And I might like to go on a cruise. How much is that one then? Buy one, get one free. Oh, OK. I see. So you can go on your own or take someone with you free of charge. There's no, not really. Here we are. Look, no flying from Tilbury and Bristol. What does it say then? Where's the Christmas one then? What's the Christmas one? October, April. Oh, is that it? Oh, yeah. Here we go. Christmas, it's a bit dearer, that one is. So that's £2,800. But that would be for two people if you knew someone else. Christmas, New Year's cruise. Oh, that's the one. That's the one I mentioned to you. So it starts on December the 17th. And how long's that for? 22 days. That's a long time to go on holiday, isn't it? That's the trouble. What if you get bored? You know, I get bored on holiday ever so easily. Have you ever been on a cruise? Where did you go? Perhaps you'd like to tell me about it on the show this afternoon. Call in if you want to. 020-8144-3477 is my phone in number. 020-8144-3477. And I've got Skype as well. My Skype in is all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Skype in is United Kingdom Talk. Alternatively, you can just tap out a message and I'll read it out for you. Ronan says, why I have one person or two I go with and we enjoy it. I don't get on with whoever, and it doesn't matter how close the friendship is, we end up rowing. And I do not like rowing, Ronan. I walk away. I hate rowing. What is the point in going on holiday and rowing with someone? It's terrible. That's why I don't go on holiday with anyone anymore. It just doesn't work. And it can destroy friendships. It can absolutely... Come on. There's got to be more than me out there who's been on holiday with someone, whether you love them or not, or they're just friends or whatever, and it's ended up a disaster because you are suddenly stuck with that person 24 hours a day. Can you just imagine being stuck with me 24 hours a day, Ronan? I bet you can't, my love. I know it's hard to believe, isn't it? You'd think I'm maybe happy and jolly and all this. Not always, dear. No. Wayney says, can you do a camera behind you? I've got one behind me, Wayney. Are you not paying attention, dear? Look, there it is. You see, it's there. Behind me. It's behind you. No, it's not. It's in front of you. It's behind you. Do pay full attention to what's going on, please, Wayney. God's sake, man. Just does it. He just pops in for a few minutes and then decides the entire show on that, doesn't he? Have you had a chance to watch my Santiago Chile video? Didn't know there was one, Ronan. I shall have a look at that later on, OK? Hello to Alan, who says, I'll be down tomorrow night at Central Station. Alan, you keep saying that, dear. You keep saying you're going to be down there and then you don't come. How can we possibly believe you, dear? I'm not going to hold my breath waiting for you to appear all the time, lovey. If you want to come, come. If you want to stay at home, stay at home. And watch it on your widescreen television. Yes, stream us. Have you got a little Google Chrome? You can beam it direct to your telly. How fabulous is that? Who's been on a cruise, anyone? Tell me all about it. Where did you go? What did you do? 020-8144-3477 is my local London number. Or you can just sit there and watch. I don't mind. Let's have a look. Daniel says, are you still doing CCTV? What do you mean CCTV? This is a worldwide television broadcast I'm doing today. Hello to Keith George, who's with us this evening. Hello, Keith. Nice to see you, sir. Stephen says, where has that finger been? Which one? This one here. It's been nowhere yet. Nowhere yet. We don't know. Adam. Adam, who's in Gran Canaria at this moment, aren't you, Adam? He's talking on the subject of eating your own skin. Look, there's a bit of thumb sticking up there. Can you see that? There's a little bit of thumb. There you can. See that there? I'll probably eat that later. Adam says, it's called recycling, eating your own body. I wonder, you know, if we were to sort of just eat ourselves like that, you know, if we were to just eat ourselves, would you still put on weight? That's the question. By eating myself, would that be classed by the government as one of my five a day? Now, there's a good question for you. See if you can work that one out. Daniel says, did you have to fill out an application form when you was a stripper? Oh, I've never had the body to be a stripper. Well, I have. I did have, actually, about between the age of 32 and 47, I could have been a stripper. I had one of those bodies. I did. And I didn't even go to the gym. I did a lot of swimming, which I still do now. But no, it's all fallen apart now, Daniel. A little bit like your own, from what I can see from your photos, lovey. Hey? When's the last time you saw a little bit of exercise, dear? Want to pop in a gymnasium or a swimming pool somewhere? Might do you the world of good, lovey. Let's just do that. Ronan says, I applied for a job on Sunday, interview Friday, and found it. Oh, well done. Well done, well done. Well done, well done. All right. Okay, let's just refresh that. I don't miss any. I don't like to miss anything. People get very upset when you don't read out their messages. Oh, it's the end of the world sometimes. Wayne says, Chris, that is beside you. I mean, behind you. I mean, well, why would you want it behind me? Why would you want it? You wouldn't be able to see my pretty boy face, Wayne. Wouldn't that be terrible? You wouldn't be able to see my pretty boy face if there was a camera behind me. Hello to Joey, who says, quick question. What was wrong with the cups that you got back the other day? Well, to be honest, I can't find anything wrong with them. Joey, I can't. But my sister is a bit of a perfectionist, so when she does mugs, if she's not happy with them, she rejects them and does another one. She is a perfectionist, my sister. Yeah. Who wants to come on a cruise with me? Don't all rush, yes. Now, here's some interesting news, boys and girls. Talking of flying, and Ronan is a aircraft steward, I think is the correct title, is that? An aircraft steward is our Ronan. Look at this. Have you seen the news, Ronan? Look at this. A futuristic subsonic passenger aircraft has got the funding it needs to take off and a test flight this year. We'll take more care of you. Fly the flag. Fly the flag. Oh, yes. Boom Supersonic said it received $33 million in funding, £26 million, and was ready to build its XB1 jet prototype. This is excellent news. I mean, how mad is it that we used to be able to get to New York in, was it an hour and a half or something? And now it takes 8 hours or 6 hours because they dumped Concorde. Just because a little bit of rubber got sucked into an engine somewhere. Yep, terrible, all those people dying. But accidents happen. You know, we don't have a crash on the M4 and suddenly they, all right, you can't use your cars anymore. So I did think that was a bit stupid. I must say, when they had that accident with Concorde, in which, I mean, an awful way to die. They were all literally burnt like being in an oven, it must have been. Oh, what a way to go. Dreadful. But it was an accident. They found out what the cause was, wasn't it? Something got sucked into the air, into the engine, and that was that. I think it's a great shame that Concorde was scrapped. I really do. Anyway, this new one is backed by Richard Branson. Oh, I've got a lot of time for him. I'd like to meet him, Richard Branson. I think he must be a bit mad like me, didn't you? I think you've got to be a bit mad to chuck loads of money at something, and you've got to believe that it's going to work, haven't you? I mean, I don't suppose everything he's done has been a success, has it? He must have had little downs now and again, but, you know, he keeps going, doesn't he? Richard Branson. The baby boom jet could be usher in a new era of affordable supersonic travel. Claimed to be the world's fastest civil aircraft ever made, the XB-1 supersonic demonstrator is due to take off on its first test flight later this year and could take passengers from London to New York in only 3.5 hours. Its maker claims. That's not bad, is it? 3.5 hours. We could just go and do shopping. Ronan, can you get me on there, Ronan? That's the job you want, Ronan. You want to work on that jet, my friend. Claimed the company said the jet, which will cost about 160 million quid to make, may carry passengers by the early 2020s. Oh, I'll be, so what's that, 17, 18, so shall we say 2022, 17, 18, 19, 20, 54, 5, 6, 7, 8, I'll be 59 then. 59 I'll be! I want to see people land on Mars, I really do. I'd like you to go to Mars. I've got you a one-way ticket to go to Mars. Would you like to send someone to Mars? Who would you like to send to Mars and why? Call in and tell me this afternoon. There must be something you want to talk about. 0208144 3477. 0208144 3477. Or you can Skype in on our Skype username, United Kingdom Talk, okay? An innovator in space, Virgin Galactic's decision to work with Boom, was an easy one. The airline tycoon has confirmed that Virgin has options to buy 10 of the recently revealed supersonic boom jets, which would be capable of flying at 1,451 miles an hour. I mean, how quickly could I get to work on one of those? I would just get in and I'm there. I would get in, say, United Kingdom Talk, and I'd be walking out the other end again. Not even time for a cup of tea. I don't know if I like the sound of that. What about my meal? What about my meal? Won't have time for dinner. It's too quick. So that's good news. That's really good news, because I do think we've gone right the way backwards when it comes to airline travel. And I do think it's an enormous shame that we haven't got Concorde or anything like that anymore, don't you? It really is. Rod says Richard Branson is very quiet with quiet speech, unlike the superstar that I am watching. Thank you, Rod. Thank you, Rod. Please never make the mistake of calling me a megastar. I am a superstar. There is only one megastar. He appears daily in a little picture behind me there and is also hiding behind my back. Look at that. Barry Manilow is behind me. Aren't I the lucky one? Paul Brown, hello Paul, says, what kind of, hello Paul, my little Paul, how are ya? Superman, what kind of cruise? Are we talking QE2 or Hampstead Heath? No, dear. No, not that sort of thing, Paul. Come on, Paul. You must have grown out of that, but, well, maybe not, darling. I grew out of that years ago. We don't worry about that sort of thing anymore. There's far more to life than going bar to bar trying to get a hookup for the night, dear. There's more to life than that. I don't know what cruise these are. It doesn't say. It just says maltravel.co.uk/bogoff. Yeah, I'm not joking, look. maltravel.co.uk/bogoff. Buy one, get one free. I don't know. Hang on, where's my blooming glasses? Let me see. Well, there's a picture of a boat there, Paul. I mean, would that be the one? Do you want to come with me? Eh? Or Russia. Oh, yeah. St. Petersburg. I'd quite like to go to Russia. That is Russia, isn't it? St. Petersburg. Look at that building in St. Petersburg and Moscow and all around there. Do you know, funny thing, the other day, I just happened to flick across to Russia Today. one of the news while I was passing through the channels. You know how you do. You flick through on the free view, don't you? It's one of the free view. Or was it free sat? Can't remember. One of the free channels anyway. And I'm just watching this bloke read the news. And I thought, do you know, I'm sure I know you. And his name came up. And I thought, oh, yeah, I remember him. I remember being in a club with him one night years and years ago. Anyway, I sent him a tweet. But he hasn't responded. Sometimes they do that, you know. There's a couple of people. I've got to tell you, there's a couple of people on the telly that I knew years ago that I've sent messages to, and they don't reply, dear. It's like they don't want to know me. Isn't that strange and mysterious? It's very strange and mysterious. It's like they don't want to know you anymore. How rude is that? Like I'm going to reveal some sort of secret about him. I'm not one of those awful girls in the sun, dear. You know, I slept with 10 Premier League footballers and they were all crap in bed. I wouldn't do that. Not my style at all. A secret is a secret I will take to the grave, which hopefully won't be for very long time yet. Good afternoon to Mark Cording. Good afternoon, Mark, who's with us this afternoon. Afternoon, Mark. So, Monday. Yeah, I thought I'd better warn you, Monday. It got extremely busy Monday, okay? It's really big. Monday appears now to be busier than the Fridays for some reason. I don't know why that's happened, but there we are. Alan says, I'd love to come with you. Alan, no, I don't think so, Alan. No, you'd be talking, dear. You'd be talking and telling me stupid jokes that aren't funny. I wish people would stop telling me stupid jokes that aren't funny. They grab you and they pull you over. Here, have you heard this one, Chris? And I'm like, huh? Oh, dear, dear me. Jokes. Adam says, I'd love to come on a cruise as well. No, we can't. I don't dare do it, Adam. No, no. We've got too strong a friendship for me to risk it going on holiday with you. It just won't work. I know it won't work. It won't work. Paul says, I was merely inquiring. Can't be asked with trolling from bar to bar. Now, I don't blame you, Paul. It's all over, isn't it, for us, be honest, Paul. Well, not for you. Look at you, darling. You can go anywhere, click your fingers and pull like that. Doesn't happen for me, I'm afraid, lovey. Not unless I get my wallet out. Then sometimes they're interested. Dean, hello to Dean. And Ray Reynolds is with us this afternoon. Afternoon, Ray. Nice to see you, Ray. All right, so that's the... techno. Now, I've got to tell you this. I've been watching that TV show, SSGB. Have you been watching that? It's on BBC One Colour. Well, it was on BBC One Colour on Sunday nights. And it's about the Germans. And they won the war. OK. And it's a drama. It's a story. OK. It's not real life. It's not real life. You know, that the Germans won the war. OK, it's a made up story. But if they'd have won the war, what could have happened? And it's an excellent series, actually. And it finished on Sunday. And the acting was good. The first show or two, the diction coming out of the actors' mouths wasn't very good. I actually had to turn the subtitles on. I've got a little button on my remote control where you can have subtitles and read some of the stuff at the bottom of the screen there. But anyway, so... The last one was on Sunday and it was great. And the German SS officer saved his English counterpart, which was quite nice. But towards the end, there was a shot of the table where the German officer had been sitting. And there was a mobile phone on there. And I don't get it. How, and presumably this was supposed to be in the 40s and 50s, was it? Have I missed something here? Because we're all dressed like 40s and 50s. And one of the last scenes was the camera took a shot. The German officer had been sitting at this table, right? His English man who had been, he was SS. I think he was SS. And the English inspector, Archer, they were both about to get caught, but he told Archer to go and hide. And he saved him. He saved him. And the German officer was taken, the SS officer was taken out by the German army and court-martialed and shot in front of a firing squad. But just before that happened, he got up from the desk
and the camera went on the desk, and there was a mobile phone on there. I don't get it. Did anyone else see that? You've got to watch it. It's the last one. I'm sure it was a mobile phone. Very, very strange indeed. Now, I looked on the internet, because often you can find, if you see something on the telly, that's not quite right, you type it into Google, and there'd be a forum somewhere, you know. I mean, there are forums with people who are into, and very, very strange people, dear, and they constantly record the television, right, waiting for something wrong to happen. You can go on YouTube and type in BBC News bloopers, and often you'll see, you know the BBC News, you know that tune. Boop, boop, and the camera comes, and there's no one sitting there. And it zooms in. Because you know that, you know on the BBC News channel, you know when the camera comes round like that, boop, boop, and it comes around, good evening, welcome to BBC, and it's all moving like that. Right, that is a pre-programmed computer thing making all that happen. So there's no one working that. It's already pre-made. And if you watch the BBC News channel, it's always the same. The camera, first of all, it goes on the office, and then the camera comes around and zooms in slowly to the person, right? That's all pre-planned. So the human newsreader has to be in the correct position. But there's no one working. Oh, he's over there, so let's move it over a bit. No, you can't do that. You've got to be there, and often they miss it like that. Did you know that? You see, I'm full of information. I really am here. Thank you. So these people, they constantly watch the television and they're recording everything, waiting for something to go wrong. And when they find something, they get ever so excited and start wetting their knickers. They have wet their knickers watching things like that happen. On my life, I've seen it happen, dear. I've been round their houses and seen little puddles of water underneath their seats. And you know, they don't change their pants often. It stinks. Ghastly. And as soon as they see something on there, they quickly put it on their computer. They do something to the video and then send it up to a forum somewhere. Oh my God. And it'll be like a headline. Oh my God. Can't believe Philip Schofield picked his nose and they got it on camera. And they get so excited that it makes their week. That is their entire lives, watching the television, waiting for something to go wrong. You're probably doing it with me here. But you see, it don't bother me. It doesn't bother me. I can pick. I don't. But I think picking nose is disgusting. You never see. Oh, have you seen people doing it in their cars? Dirty bastards. That should be done as well. As well as the using mobile phones, people need to be nicked for picking their nose at the wheel. Dirty people. And women. You know, they're going along. They're going along slowly in traffic. Keep eye on doing lipstick and eyes. What's all that about? I saw another bloke this week watching the telly as he's driving along. All these people need to be nicked. And that's all there is to it. But that's what those people do. They constantly watch, waiting for things to go wrong. They do. Paul says, such flattery. You've always been lovely to me, though. For much supposed to be close to two decades. Is it two decades? You're probably right, Paul. It's got to be two decades. How old are you now, Paul? Are you late? Ooh. Okay, I'm going to guess Paul's age. One moment, please. Right, well, the picture of you in the Superman top makes you look about 20... Oh, hang on a minute. Dark rings under those eyes, lovey. Just a minute now, let's have a look. You look about 23 in the picture of you with the Superman thing. Oh, there's one of you with blonde spiky hair... Like that, in that photo, oh, I don't really want to say, Paul. You know, we've been friends a long time, lovey. I don't want to upset you by telling me. But what about the one of you with your mum? Okay. How old are you? Now, let's see. Oh, 37. I'm guessing your age at 37, Paul. How old are you now, lovey? Eh? 37. Is that a good estimate? That is an honest estimate. I won't lie to you. Won't lie to you. 36. There you go. I'm almost bang on then, Paul, aren't I? Happy birthday, Paul. 36. Gosh, where's all those years gone? Do you know, this November, it will be 10 years since I left the Black Cap. 10 years. There's still a wonderful group of people trying to get that reopened, you know. I mean, I don't know. Will it or won't it? It never be what we had. You see, that time has moved on now. But you never know. Things happen, don't they? All right. Alan's estimating you at 37 to 38. So, yeah, we're all around that, Paul. You know, if I was 36, anywhere between 32. Well, I mean, the lower, the better. Yeah. The lower, the better, to be honest. But if I was 36 and someone said, yeah, you look about 37, 30, I'll be happy with that. That's all right. That's all right. I can still get away with early 40s. Can you believe that, lovey? No. Early 40s. Do I look early 40s? I tell you what, Paul, I can't take my top off anymore when I'm DJing. That just doesn't look right, lovey. You know, it'd be like going and watch your granddad DJing. Never mind, we're still here. That's all we can be grateful for. Hello to Terry H in Leeds, who says, I've seen you pick your nose live on air. Well, no. What you've seen me do is this. You've seen me do this. I get an incredibly itchy nose. It's okay today, actually. No problem at all today. I've never picked my nose while doing a show. Or otherwise, actually. I don't pick my nose. Oh, it's just disgusting. I might give it a really good poot like this. I like doing that. Apparently, you're not supposed to do that. Did you know that? You're supposed to blow carefully one nostril at a time. But you don't get the same effect, do you? Nothing better than have a good blow of your nose. No. Rod Brown says, P&O cruise would be nice. Pubs and off licences. Well, on the actual cruise. Oh, that's nice. You see, the thing is, I don't really drink, Rod. The only time I drink really is if I might have a glass of champagne on a plane. That's about it. Or if I go to one of my four or five times a year afternoon teas. I quite like doing that. You go to like a nice hotel. Well, I've done it in London a few times. I do it out here now. There's a place called Coworth Park. I went twice last year, actually. Once with Auntie Brenda and once with my mate Ron. And it's the most beautiful house. And meadow. They've created a meadow with all these wildflowers. Oh, it's lovely, Rod. And you can have an afternoon tea for about 30 quid. You know, get endless amounts of sandwiches and tea. And if you want to have a glass of champagne, that's a bit extra, I think that is. But I'll be going around a few more of those perhaps this year and taking the cameras of United Kingdom Talk with me to help keep you entertained for your summer days with no takings from the TV licence. All right. Okay. Dying for another cup of tea, I think, really. Paul says, I tend not to take my top off in bars anymore either. Yes, you're probably right there, lovey. I think you're right there. Oh, dear. Right, here's some more information for you. Vegetarians. Any vegetarians? Just me again, is it? Huh? It's only me, isn't it? Never mind. But anyway, here's a story, in today's Daily Mail. With a brown exterior and juicy pink inside. Now, anyone who's just joined the show is probably wondering what the hell I'm talking about now. Phone lines are still open, okay? Last chance to call in now, 020-8144. Oh, my God, Adam's called in. That was quick. Blimey, I only just flashed the number up there. Hello, Adam, how are you today?
I'm all right, Chris, and yourself?
You're in... Oh, can you hear me?
I can, yes.
You're in Gran Canaria, aren't you?
I have. Have you twiddled your knob?
I have twiddled my knob. I nearly forgot then. Do you like the three-camera effect now, Adam?
I do. Very, very BBC colour.
And it's fantastic. I'll be honest, the other camera I bought for something else. But I've installed it now, and I think it's going to have to stay there.
Now, I think that next you'll be having camera going around on the track around the
one of those what comes round on the news channel or something like that.
yeah.
What's happening, Adam? Go on, mate. You're on holiday at the moment. When did you get there?
Yesterday.
Was the flight okay, or was there turbulence?
Oh, no turbulence at all. No screaming people, unfortunately.
Oh, how boring is that? There's nothing better than always a little bit of turbulence. Ah, they're screaming, we're going to die, we're going to die. I love it, dear. Continue.
Got off the aeroplane and went out to find my little bus, got my bus.
Yeah.
And the bus was full of screaming children and women.
Oh, so you got a bus. You didn't get a cab then?
No, I got a bus.
Very good. Very good indeed.
£12.
Is that all? And
yeah,
did you know that before you got there, or did you just ask someone at the airport?
Oh, no. It was all, I booked it all. I used an agent called On the Beach.
Oh, right. Yes. Okay.
I used an agent called On the Beach for the booking.
Yes.
And I had the choice of either a minicab or a bus, and I just thought, I'll just get the bus. I don't want to spend 40-odd quid on a minicab.
I don't blame you. I don't think I'm really brave enough to do that. Unless I'm in an English-speaking country. I did it in Australia. Oh, that was bloody hard work. Because I took the train. I took the train in, and I think then I had to get like an underground train type thing in Sydney.
Gotcha, yep.
And so I got to the stop. And remember, I was going for 3 weeks on this bloody great big suitcase, and it was heavy. And I got off the train, you know, walked along, and then there were these stairs, and there was no lift. Oh, my God. I don't know how I got up these stairs. That would be in Hyde Park. They've got a Hyde Park in Sydney. And I walked up and got to the hotel like that. No, absolutely. Top marks you for getting a bus in a foreign country like that, yeah. Because I get very scared that I'm going to get lost. I get really scared I'm going to get lost.
Well, so do I, especially with my dyslexia, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, I booked it for On the Beach. Now, the only disappointing thing was that it said including 10 kilos of luggage. Now, I misread that. That's hand luggage.
Right.
They didn't include the luggage. I had to pay for the luggage at the airport, 40 quid.
40 quid?
Mm.
So what did they include?
Hand luggage of 10 kilos. So, of course, I weighed out my suitcase for 10 kilos.
Right.
Thinking that would be okay. And, of course, it was for hand luggage.
Ah, right. Okay.
I suppose I could have got away with putting it in the overhead hall. Like,
well, no. They've got a little device there that they will put your bag in and see if it fits in the device. If not, it goes in the hold.
Gotcha.
You've got to be wary of that. So that's going to cost you 40 quid again when you go back the other way, I'm afraid. It might be worth booking it on... before you get on the plane, that might be cheaper.
Mm. It was. Now, this is the problem, Chris. I could have booked checked in the luggage online, but because On the Beach had done the booking, they used their generic credit card. So when I went to put my details in, it wouldn't allow me. It says you have used it on credit card.
And of course, say that again.
Right, because the holiday was booked through the agent.
Yes.
The agent had used a generic credit card, like one of their own credit cards that they used to book the holiday with.
Yes.
To pay for the holiday. So what that actually meant was that when I went to go and check my luggage in online, when I realised what happened, I tried to check it in online, and I couldn't because they'd used their credit card. And when I put my credit card details into the online booking form, it said, this is not the correct credit card.
Oh.
So I had to. Unfortunately, it was after 7 in the evening that I realised this, and of course I was flying out the next morning at 7:20, and they didn't open until 8. So there's no way I could check it in. But what I'll do now I'm out here,
yes,
I will ring them. I'll ring them and get them to book my bag in on the way back.
What estate? What travel agent is that then?
It's an online one called On the Beach.
Okay, I don't know them.
No, they're On the Beach. I mean, they're very good. They're quite cheap with their hotels and flights and stuff. They normally give you quite good deals. But unfortunately, you've got to watch things like that. You know, you've got
to watch
that's
a shame. Yeah.
But because I'm not used to travelling, you see, I missed it. That's all it was.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you know now. You see the trouble you got in on the plane there? You see, that's just one little thing that can go wrong. That's why I don't fly. I can't bear it.
Airline was wonderful, Norwegian.
I will fly again, but I'd rather not. You know, if there's another way to get somewhere, I'd rather take the other route there. So you enjoyed did you get something to eat on the plane?
Say again, sorry.
Did you get something to eat on the plane?
No, that wasn't included either.
Oh. Would you get a cup of tea?
No, you had to buy all that if you wanted anything.
Okay.
But I wasn't that worried because, I mean, the return flight on Norwegian was £90.
Oh, that's not bad, is it?
Mm. You know, so I'm not really. I mean, it's only a 4-hour flight. If you can't survive 4 hours without eating,
Yeah. Did you find the seat a bit small? I know you had a row to yourself, didn't you?
No, I had a whole row to myself. No, not at all. They're really nice big seats on Norwegian. That's what I like about them.
Okay.
Unlike EasyJet, where you're neither...
Dreadful. Keith George has just written in to say, when you travel first class, you can have three bags in the hold, 32 kilos each. Yeah, I know, wow. Keith. Oh, you know it. Anyway, go on, Adam.
Yeah, so, the trip was really, really nice and easy and no problems at all, very welcoming.
Right.
And got to the hotel and welcomed me in, and it's a one-bedroom apartment. And,
nice and clean.
I went down to very extremely clean, extremely
big. Is it quite big? Big enough for one person? Is it for two people?
Oh, it's actually got two single beds in it. So,
all right, yeah.
I could invite a guest over.
Okay.
So it's two single beds, and it's really spacious. Last night I went out to the local shopping centre called the Yambo Centre.
Yumbo. It's called. Oh yeah, you were saying that on your. No, it's Yumbo, dear.
Yumbo.
Y-U-M-B-O. You kept saying Yambo.
Oh, Yumbo.
That would be Y-A, dear. It's Y-U. Yumbo Centre. Go on. Let me just get myself comfortable, dear.
Yeah, so I had a look round. I mean, did you want to go off and get a cup of tea while I tell the story?
No, not at all, because I've got to disappear soon anyway. So you carry on, darling.
So, yeah, I went to the Yumbo Centre last night and had a look around the local shops there, as it were, and quite a few interesting things in the shops to look at, and had a nice little drink with a few young gentlemen.
Yes.
So it was an interesting evening. Of course, it's International Bears Week out here. So
International what?
Well at the moment. It's International Bears Week.
Bears?
Bears, yeah.
Oh, they're the big people, aren't they?
Yeah, that's it. So
okay,
So I could actually get away with taking my top off in the bar without people.
Yeah, because you'd be classed as a bear, but you're not hairy enough, are you?
No, I'm not.
Do you not have to be hairy to be a bear or just fat?
I'm not really sure.
Well, you must inquire, dear. Can you ask one of them for me?
I will do, yeah.
You know, maybe I'll just start eating the crisps again. I could become a bear.
You've got a little beard. Can you imagine you with a beard?
No. Ooh. No, I hate it. Oh, dear, I've just burped. How awful. Live on air as well. How dreadful that one. Did you hear it just came out?
Oh,
it just suddenly came out. I burped. How dreadful. I do apologise. You probably thought you were watching some amateur TV programme then, boys and girls, like Sky News. I do apologise. Continue.
Oh, dear. Yeah, so I shall make the inquiry if I go back to the Yumbo Centre and see what's going on down there. It was an interesting place, I must say that.
What's it called again?
The Yumbo.
Yumbo Centre, correct. Yumbo. When you do your video tomorrow, you must correct yourself, dear. Yumbo Centre. Y-U. Yeah. Yumbo.
Umbo, that's it. Yeah,
so where are you eating? Where are you eating?
Oh, just the local restaurants and shops and what have you.
Right,
so,
okay.
Looking around and seeing the interesting foods.
Is it a very big hotel you're in? I know your rooms.
There's five floors, and I'm on the third floor.
Right.
They're all individual one-bedroom apartments.
Yes.
I presume some of them might be bigger. The ground floor ones, I think, are two or three-bedroom apartments.
But, family does, yeah.
I mean, that was only 260 for the 6 day. Because I arrived on the Wednesday and I leave on the Monday. So for that period of time, it's only £260.
That's not bad, is it, for a little holiday like that? Good. Have you been to the beach?
Not yet. That's only down the road. That's sort of literally at the end of the road. So it's
too
far to go down there. But today it's a bit overcast and cloudy, even though it's still warm. People are still walking around in T-shirts.
I never found the beach. I went three times. I couldn't find the beach.
All right. Okay.
Never found it. Keith says, he wants to know, did you go to construction or a club?
I went to Sparkles, a place called Sparkles.
Sparkles, that's a show place, is it, where they do shows?
That's right.
Was that busy?
Yeah. Yeah, it was fairly packed. I've done a bit of karaoke and got a sitting ovation.
A sitting ovation. How many was in there then?
Must have been about 100.
100, okay, yeah.
Yeah, give or take. So yeah,
there's a lovely one of the clubs is lovely. It's got a bath in it. I don't know what that's for. They actually got a bath in the club. Very odd.
Oh,
no idea what that's for.
Investigate that one.
Yeah, do have a look around. That might be construction, actually. I think that's the one with the bath in it. Very odd.
Very odd. We'll go and have a look at that, being Adam the plumber.
Yeah, don't forget to take your camera in with you as well.
Yes, I will.
You could do a live, a Facebook live from construction.
That would be interesting, wouldn't it?
Oh, dear. Well, you'll be out again tonight. I should have told you, actually, a bit pointless going out until about midnight there. There doesn't seem to be anyone around sort of early on. Did you find that? You've got the big event there, haven't you?
Say again, sorry?
You've got the event there at the moment, so that might be different.
Yeah, but the Bears event seems to be busy. Yeah. I sort of got a bit lost in the centre, various places in the centre, and didn't get until 5 a.m.
Yes,
which I haven't done since the days of trade.
Blimey, what time did you get back to your room?
About 6 o'clock.
God dear me, I can't remember the last time I did that. Tonight, work-wise, tonight is my late night. Like, I'm 2 o'clock tonight.
Mm-hmm.
And at about 1 o'clock, I start going down very quickly because it's not my normal time anymore. In fact, sometimes this particular place I work on Thursdays, the two brewers I work on Thursdays, sometimes I go till 3 on a Thursday. I've now given those dates back to someone. Back to the other DJ because I don't think I can do them anymore. I just start falling asleep. And if you're falling asleep, you can't give it your best anyway, you know, once you start falling asleep, you know.
This is true, I know what you mean. I mean, this is it's my longest time out. Since those days. So it was interesting, to say the least.
That is so late, so late.
Just literally sitting in a cafe today, drinking cola late.
Are you?
And watching the world go by at the moment.
Is it warm enough to sit by the pool or not?
The sun's just literally come out from behind the clouds at the moment.
Right, okay.
And there's a bit of a breeze in the air.
Yes. There's a club called XL.
XL,
Is it still there? Yeah, I DJed there for a week once.
Mm.
Yeah, I just happened to be on the island and I always used to take my CDs with us anywhere. And it was the weirdest thing ever. I got this phone call in reception. So it's all so-and-so. Has asked if you could ring him. So I rang this bloke. His name's Michael. I said, oh, it's Michael. Oh, hello, Chris. Mm-hmm. He said, I run, was it Heaven or XL? I worked at them both, actually.
Mm.
It was either one or the other. We heard you're on the island. Have you got your songs with you? I said, yeah. Well, would you like to come and DJ for us for a couple of nights? So I did. Yeah, that was quite nice, you know. But how do they know I'm here? that was when I was
before the days of Facebook and everything.
That was when I was popular young hot DJ. Not anymore.
You'll always be a young hot DJ to me, Chris.
From DJ Adam to television, international television personality and superstar. Look at that, love.
That's what you are.
Well, you have a lovely time tonight. Perhaps I don't know if I'm doing a show tomorrow. Fridays tends to be a bit pushed for time, but certainly Friday or Saturday. Mm-hmm. You can give us more insight into the fun to be had on Gran Canaria.
Indeed.
All right.
Thanks for your time and have a wonderful day.
And you have a lovely time on holiday. All right. Speak to you soon. Bye bye, Adam.
Cheers, Chris. Bye.
Adam the plumber there. Yeah, he needs a nice time on holiday, doesn't he? All right, we'll close the phone lines now, boys and girls. Lines are now closed. Boo! And we're just about to finish now. Let me do today's birthdays for you. We've got a few birthdays today, boys and girls. Happy birthday today to Ian Sharp, who is one of our karaoke extraordinary singers. Happy birthday, Ian, 74 today. You seem to have about 5 different Facebook profiles. I don't know how you manage that, but happy birthday to Ian Sharp. Happy birthday to Justin Staunton, 44 today. Happy birthday, Justin, to Shanae Sinan. Oh, Sinan, hello. 33 today. Sinan is 33 today. I remember you. I haven't seen you for ages, Sinan. Perhaps you must come down to Central Station Karaoke one day, dear. John Hutchinson today is 61 years old. Gemma Gardner, 34 today. Happy birthday, Jenna. Gemma. Bradley Cooper's birthday today. Tim Beckett, we've got a lot of birthdays today. Meredith Ryan Carpen, I think you're one of our Manolo girls. Happy birthday, Meredith. Beautiful name. And Orion Fitzsimmons today. Just a young 24 today. Happy birthday, Orion. And, that's it. There's another four profiles from Ian Sharp there. So let's sing the song and we'll disappear today, boys and girls, okay? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Have a wonderful day, boys and girls. Tonight, it's a Thursday night, so I'll be DJing tonight at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Okay, no, incorrect. Incorrect. Tonight is Thursday. I'll be DJing. So many jobs there. I'll be DJing tonight at the Tubero in Clapham High Street. That starts at 10 o'clock through until 2. There's always cabaret on as well. I don't know what it is. They haven't put that up yet, but unfortunately. But there'll be cabaret on as well with me, all right? So tonight at the Tubero, DJing on this Thursday night and every Thursday from 10 o'clock. And I'm just asking, do I have a light on the mirror ball today? No, why? Oh, it's the sun. The sun's coming in through the window. That's where the light's coming from. All right. Well, that's it today, boys and girls. Thank you very much for joining us. And I shall see you again very soon. Enjoy your Thursday. And I'll see you soon. Bye-bye now.